Good morning. Good morning, students. So we are here to discuss today about file system. So we people used to manage and maintain the file system earlier, and so file system have some drawbacks. So to eliminate those drawbacks, to remove the major disadvantages of file system drawbacks, there was a need to have new system. So that kind of new system was database evolution and database development. So in today's class we will discuss the file system drawbacks, and what is database. So database is a collection of organized information that is persistent and consistent to store, retrieve, manipulate and manage their databases in a effective and efficient manner. So what are the drawbacks of a file system? In fourth generation languages, earlier the programmers and users work with file system. File-based oriented system, that is a conventional file-oriented system. So, in the files, people use it to store the data in a file. So having the data structures, and what I mean to say, you will be having the arrays, pointers and other things. So they are only to process at that moment, and the data is not stored anywhere. So to store the data permanently, the software persons used to store the files, used to work with the files, and the file will have fields and the records. So the fields are the individual data items, and they are not having any relevance, but a field name must be very clear, and that is meaningful, and it should not be ambiguous. You can say XYZ. So what is XYZ? XYZ is a field name, of course, but after some time, after 2 years or 3 years, when you look at back, so what for you use is that variable XYZ. Instead of that, if you use name, customer ID, student number, and like that, it is meaningful. Okay, so the people use it to work with the files, and file systems have certain drawbacks because it requires very extensive programming features in order to have new reports from the different files. The files must be more than one. So you can use different files for different purposes. So the formats are also different, and the fields will be scattered. In such a case, it is very difficult to extract the required information by having the association of the files. So relationship with the files. That's why the programmers require extensive programming abilities, and the file systems cannot perform ad hoc. Means suppose you want certain data from the files, so by having some of the fields of different files in a different kind of report, so ad hoc queries. So file systems cannot able to perform ad hoc queries. So that is also a drawback of file system. So as the files are having independent and they are individual files that are maintained, and for each work, so there is a separate file. For example, for a customer maintenance file, it is a customer file. So for a loans account file, so there is a file, loans file, and current account, and the other deposits account, and so they use it to maintain different files in different formats. So what exactly happened? The fields are scattered, and which is very difficult and for the system administration to have the required report. So it is the system administration become lengthy and difficult. System administration is becoming lengthy and difficult. So it cannot give accurate required output because you need to make so many changes in the existing structures. So the file system requires to perform good number of changes, many changes. So need to make changes in the existing structure. Yes, already a table is created having good number of fields, and data is also stored, and when you want some kind of reports by having interrelation of the files, so sometimes it requires to make some of the changes in the existing files regarding to the fields. And in the file system, the data is not consistent, the data is inconsistent data. So this is because there is a redundancy of the data. Redundancy means duplication of the data in the files. So for the same customer or for the same employee or for a particular person, the repetition of data that took place in different files. So wherever the redundancy, duplication or repetition of the data occurs, there comes the inconsistency of the data. So file system should not have consistent data. It is having inconsistency, and this is because redundancy of data. And moreover, file systems have no proper security. Anybody can access the data at any time. Okay, so there is no security measures that is to be adopted, and file systems is having no security. Even if it is having security, it is less security. And security features are very inadequate. Inadequate means it is very less. So that to overcome and eliminate these drawbacks of the file system, the need comes to have a new alternative system, that is database management system. Okay, these are the drawbacks of the file system, file oriented system and conceptual file system. So the first one is, so it requires extensive programming, and the programming productivity is also low programming productivity, and the programmers requires extensive programming abilities, and you cannot perform ad hoc, or so you want to have some kind of new report by joining or having the relationship of the other files. So it cannot perform the ad hoc queries, and the system administration becomes very difficult to maintain, and it needs to make changes in the existing structure, and the data repetition or duplication of the data occurs in different files, and there it created inconsistency of the data. The data is not consistent, and there is no security in the file-oriented system. In that case, the new software introduced, that is the database management system. So database management system is a collection of organized information, and the primary goal of the database is to store, retrieve, manage, manipulate, and maintenance of the database in an effective way. So that is the database management system. So to overcome all these pitfalls or drawbacks of the file oriented system, so the database is introduced. So DBMS. So I told you already, database is a collection of organized information, and maintenance of the database, such as insertion of the records, new records, or deletion of the records, organizing the records, processing the records as per the user's requirement and need, processing the complete database, and querying the database, so generating the required output. So that is a database that can come and support many different types of the databases. So you do have single user databases and multi user databases. So in the single user databases, only one person can work with the one system, and he will be having the storage, and he is having the database software, and he will be developing the applications, and he is working with his system to make any business decisions or working with the database. That is individual, so single user database. So it is not having any sharing or relevance with the other computers. So whereas in the multi-user databases, the multiple users can concurrently access and process, manipulate the data that is stored in the database. So it is a database is a logical repository of the data, and having the applications that are maintaining that data. Okay, now so the databases are classified according to the number of users working with the database, and database location where the data is stored, the software resides, and expected type of the extent of the use of the database, So suppose single user database is 90, multi user database is 90. There are single user databases, and the single user databases supports and run on a single computer, single desktop. Single user databases support only one system, or you can call it as, so maybe it is your desktop computer, or you may say that it is a laptop computer. So single user uses the database and store and develop the application and working with a single user databases. For example, DBase, DBase 2, DBase 3, DBase 4, DBase 4 Plus, Fox Pro, Fox Plus, they are all single user databases. Only users will have the database software, and they are having the applications developed, and they are working with the databases. Ultimately, maybe in their business, and they are taking the decisions. It is not having any shared ability to share the data across the computers. Okay, multi-user database and the multi-user databases support multiple users to share and work with the same database at a time. So this is what? A single user database works with only one single system or with only one person, whereas the multiple databases, you can work with multiple users. So the multiple users can share the database across the system to perform the operations. Okay, now, so the database that is having a small number of users, small number of users within an organization. So the work group database under. So a database is having limited number of persons working with that database is known as a work group database. So this is limited number of users working with this database is known as work group database. Whereas if it, the same data, so database supports many users, good number of users across the many departments, accounts department, sales department, marketing department, employee recruitment department. So within an organization, if many number of users are working and having many departments, then you have to enterprise database. Enterprise database. Many users in several departments. They are all using the database and working with the database for storage, processing and other things, then it is called enterprise database. Suppose a database is there that supports and store data in a particular location. Oka single site lo ganaka data storage ayind ankonde, dani central database. Central database data and software stored at a single location. Single location. So that is known as central database. So central database means the database supports data distribution and the data is stored at a single centralized location. So that is a centralized database. If in case the database stored in different sites and different locations and the data is distributed across many number of users, okay, now, so then that kind of database is, that database is operational database. Operational database. Operational database. So the data is shared across multiple locations. So the operational database performs, the operational database performs the day-to-day operations, the day-to-day operations, and it is a transactional database anachu leda operational database anachandi. Tarvata దాని పర్పస్ డిఫరెంట్గా ఉంటుంది, అంటే దాని ఆపరేషనల్ డేటాబేస్ అంటారు. టు పెర్ఫామ్ ది డే టు డే యాక్టివిటీస్ ఆఫ్ ది డేటాబేస్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు ప్రొవైడ్ డేటా ఎనామలీస్, డేటా ఇంటిగ్రిటీ, డేటా కన్సిస్టెన్సీ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. సో బేసికల్లీ డేటాబేస్ ఈజ్ అ కలెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ దట్ ఈస్ స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ ఏ టేబుల్ హ్యావింగ్ rows and columns. So it must be a tabular form. Okay, what are the advantages of the database? Database advantages enti ante in comparison to the file oriented system. So advantages of the database.
So these are the classifications of the database, and the database that is being used, that is being used by different people in
for different purposes.
So advantages of the database, advantages of DBMS. So first of all,
yes, there are some of the drawbacks in the file system. Yes, there is no data sharing, right? So even if the data sharing is there, it is very limited. And whereas here
in the databases, the data is improved data sharing. Alage akkada
file system lo uncontrolled data redundancy means repetition of the data means duplication of the data. So in file system then control this chele poyvaru. So here
there is improved data redundancy. Improved data redundancy
that is there. So where the data redundancy is very less, that is minute, there the data becomes consistent.
So data consistency is there. Data is consistent data.
So there it is uncontrolled data redundancy. Here that can be improved, and as it is the less data redundancy, data consistency is also improved. Then data can be accessed by different users. So that is
improved data access over multiple users across multiple systems. So that is improved data access over multiple places
by using the multiple users. And so this will give the end users productivity work. So productivity is good.
User productivity. So it will help to take exact and proper decision making with the ultimate and final reports.
So this is the advantages of the database: improved data sharing, improved data redundancy, consistency of the data, improved data access, and multiple users so concurrently access the same data at a time and work with the databases, and user productivity is there, and you can have decisions, correct and proper decisions that can be taken. Okay, so moreover, the security is very high
in the database. High security for the data. So these are all the advantages of database management system: improved data sharing, improved data redundancy, consistency in data, improved data access across the system by using the multiple users. So user productivity is there, and reduce your data redundancy. It will reduce and minimize the data redundancy. So high security is there for the data, and the users or the management can take the ultimate decisions in their business organizations. Okay, so these are all the advantages of databases when you look back into the over the file system. Okay, now database is basically used to manage ఆర్గనైజేషనల్ డేటా. ఆర్గనైజేషన్కి డే టు డే ఆపరేషన్స్ ఉంటాయి కదండి, డే టు డే ఆపరేషన్స్ వాటిని పెర్ఫామ్ చేయడానికి ద డేటాబేస్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ సిస్టమ్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్. సో to organize the data, to maintain the entities, and to create the database logical and physical structures, manipulate the data, extracting the queries, generating the reports, and everything. So the DBA will plan and design the structures and developing the different programs, and it will be assigned to the application programmers to develop the different programs and install the database software and to administrate, monitor and manage, and ultimately to take the business decisions. So the one more important task is, data may get any problem at any moment of time, at any point of time, due to the technical errors or technical problems that will be arise. So every day the people who exactly having sensitive and important data, they have to take the backup and recovery. So databases will provide to take the backup every day, and in case of database crash, then they can recover it from the previously taken backup. So database provides this one more important feature, that is database backup and recovery feature. So these are the advantages of a database management system. Improved data sharing, improved data redundancy. That means there in the file system it is uncontrolled, here it is the controlled data redundancy. So improved consistency in the data, then you can access the data for data anomalies. The user productivity is there. Data is highly secured with the privileged user passwords and protection. So you are going to give privileges to such only some of the users, and they only log in into the database and they can work with the database. So database also maintains who is the user, when they are logged in, and then when they are logged out, and how they are worked, so what files they have used. So everything that will maintain, and user productivity is there, high security is there for the databases, and the user productivity is there. And moreover, in the databases, the database provides a backup and a recovery procedure in case on any reason if the data is lost or data crash. Okay, these are the advantages of the database. So nowadays database management system is growing. Nowadays database systems are growing of its use and working environment. So what are the things to be considered when you plan the database? Yes, there are good number of databases that are supporting multi-user databases. So the database designer must think the cost of the database, the cost of the database software. So it is not to be easily get it copied from somebody's computer. It is not to be pirated. It must be purchased. So what is the software it costs? SAP. Okay na? So alage Oracle tarvata Ingress, Informix, Sybase, these are the object-oriented databases. So we have to consider and think of the cost of the database software and the utility of the software in the organization. In your organization, then utility anta, then future growth anta. So suppose in future, if the data becomes more and more larger, so can it accommodate? Okay na? So processing speed, అదే స్పీడ్ లో ఉంటుందా? అంటే తక్కువ డేటా ఉందనుకోండి, సో ఇట్ విల్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ వెరీ ఫాస్ట్. ఇఫ్ ద డేటా బికమ్స్ మోర్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గ్రోయింగ్, సో ఇట్ టేక్స్ సమ్ టైమ్, బట్ కెన్ ఇట్ అఫోర్డ్ ఇట్? సో కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రొడక్టివ్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ అండ్ ఇంక్రిమెంటింగ్ కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎంప్లాయీస్. అప్లికేషన్ డెవలప్మెంట్స్కి డేటాబేస్ మీకు స్కిల్డ్ పీపుల్ ఉండాలి. సో సపోజ్ డేటాబేస్ డెవలపర్స్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ ఏమైనా డెవలప్ చేశారనుకోండి, అప్లికేషన్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్, కానీ యూజర్స్లో కూడా హౌ దే ఆర్ యూజ్ టు వర్క్ విత్ ది డేటాబేస్ అండ్ దే మస్ట్ హ్యావ్ ద బేసిక్ ఆపరేషన్స్ దట్ ఆర్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు పెర్ఫామ్ ఆన్ ది డేటాబేస్. సో ఇఫ్ ద పీపుల్ ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ నాట్ సఫిషియంట్ స్కిల్స్, ల్యాక్ ఆఫ్ స్కిల్స్, ద యూజర్ గ్రూప్స్ మస్ట్ బి ట్రైన్. ఆ యూజర్ గ్రూప్స్ వాళ్ళకి, అంటే యూజర్ గ్రూప్స్ని ట్రైన్ చేయాలంటే ఎక్స్పర్ట్స్ని తీసుకొచ్చి వాళ్ళకి ట్రైనింగ్ ఇవ్వాలి, అంటే ఇట్ విల్ కాస్ట్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద ట్రైనింగ్ టు ది యూజర్ గ్రూప్స్, యూజర్ గ్రూప్స్కి? అలాగే అప్లికేషన్ డెవలప్మెంట్కి ఎంత కాస్ట్ అవుతుంది? సపోజ్ యు ఆర్ మేబీ ఏ ప్రోగ్రామర్ అండ్ ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఇన్ సి లాంగ్వేజ్ ఆర్ ఇన్ సమ్ అదర్ లాంగ్వేజ్, బట్ యూ వాంట్ టు డెవలప్ ది అప్లికేషన్ ఇన్ ద డేటాబేస్. సో యూ మస్ట్ నో ద సింటాక్స్ అండ్ డిజైనింగ్ ద ఫిజికల్ అండ్ లాజికల్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్, ఎవ్రీథింగ్. సో యూ సమ్టైమ్స్ పీపుల్ విల్ గివ్ ఇట్ ద డెవలప్మెంట్ జాబ్ టు ది అవుట్సోర్సింగ్ ఏజెన్సీస్. సో ఇన్ సచ్ కేస్ హౌ మచ్ ఇట్ కాస్ట్ ఫర్ ది డెవలప్మెంట్ అండ్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ ద ట్రైనింగ్ టు ది యూజర్ గ్రూప్స్. యూజర్ గ్రూప్స్ వాట్ ఐ మీన్ టు సే, ద ఆపరేటర్స్ ఆర్ ద పీపుల్ హూ యాక్చువల్లీ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ వర్కింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది డేటాబేస్. ఓకేనా? సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు కన్సిడర్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్: కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ డిజైనింగ్, కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్స్టాలేషన్, ఇంప్లిమెంటేషన్, మెయింటెనెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది డేటాబేస్ ఫర్ ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఫ్రమ్ టైమ్ టు టైమ్. సో ద డిఫరెంట్ బెనిఫిట్స్ ఆఫ్ వాట్ వీ హ్యావ్ ఆల్రెడీ డిస్కస్డ్, ద డేటాబేస్ ఓవర్ ది ఫైల్ సిస్టమ్. ఫైల్ సిస్టమ్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ సర్టెన్ డ్రాబ్యాక్స్. టు ఓవర్కమ్ అండ్ ఎలిమినేట్ దోస్ డ్రాబ్యాక్స్, ఏ న్యూ సిస్టమ్ డేటాబేస్ ఈజ్ ఇంట్రడ్యూస్డ్. సో దట్ విల్ మేక్ ది రిడ్యూస్డ్ డేటా రిడెండెన్సీ డేటాబేసెస్, రిడక్షన్ ఇన్ ద కాస్ట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ది మెయింటెనెన్స్, ఇంప్రూవ్డ్ మెయింటెనెన్స్, అలాగే టు ప్రొవైడ్ ద వర్క్ గ్రూప్ సాలరీస్. సో యూ కెన్ ఆల్సో మెయింటైన్ యాజ్ ఏ అప్లికేషన్ ఇన్ ది డేటాబేస్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్, సేవింగ్ కాస్ట్ డ్యూ టు ద రిడక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ది టైమ్ అండ్ జనరేటింగ్ ద రిపోర్ట్స్. సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మాన్యువల్లీ టు బి డన్, ఇట్ టేక్స్ గుడ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ డేస్, ఇట్ టేక్స్ మోర్ టైమ్. వేరేస్ వెన్ ద థింగ్స్ ఆర్ ప్రాపర్లీ ప్లాన్డ్, అరేంజ్డ్, ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ అండ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్, సో ఇట్ గివ్స్ లెస్ టైమ్ టు జనరేట్ ది రిక్వైర్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ సో ఫర్ ది ఆర్గనైజేషన్. అలాగే ఎస్టిమేటెడ్ కాస్ట్ ఇన్ డెవలపింగ్ ది ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ సిస్టమ్. సో ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ సిస్టమ్ ఈజ్ ద కలెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఇంటిగ్రేటెడ్ కంపోనెంట్స్. సో దేర్ ఈజ్ ఎ ఫ్లెక్సిబిలిటీ టు మీట్ అవుట్ ద యూజర్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్ అండ్ టు జనరేట్ ది రిపోర్ట్స్ యాజ్ పర్ ది యూజర్ డిమాండెడ్. నాకు రిపోర్ట్ ఈ విధంగానే వస్తుంది కాబట్టి ఈ రిపోర్ట్ ఈ విధంగానే నేను జనరేట్ చేసి మీకు ఇవ్వగలను, నో. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు డెవలప్ ది అవుట్పుట్ ఆర్ రిపోర్ట్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ది యూజర్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్ సో దట్ సో ఇట్ విల్ హ్యావ్ బెటర్ ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ మెయింటెనెన్స్ విత్ హై సెక్యూరిటీ. ఓకే, సో డేటా ఈజ్ అఫ్ కోర్స్ కన్సిస్టెంట్ అండ్ కంట్రోల్డ్ డేటా రిడెండెన్సీ అండ్ బెటర్ స్టాండర్డ్స్, బెటర్ ఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ స్టాండర్డ్స్ అండ్ సో దట్ ద అప్లికేషన్స్ విల్ జనరేట్ హై ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ ప్రొడక్టివిటీ. ఓకేనా? సో ఎన్హాన్స్మెంట్స్ కానీ మోడిఫికేషన్స్ కానీ, సో ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ ఎనీథింగ్ టు బి అప్డేటెడ్ ఆర్ యూ వాంట్ సమ్ మోర్ ఎడిషనల్ రిపోర్ట్స్ టు బి జనరేటెడ్, సో ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈజ్ పాసిబుల్ ఇన్ ది డేటాబేస్ మెయింటెనెన్స్. ఓకే, ఎన్హాన్స్మెంట్స్, మోడిఫికేషన్స్, న్యూ రిపోర్ట్స్ కెన్ బి జనరేటెడ్. సో పీపుల్ డిఫరెంట్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ ది డేటాబేస్. సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, సో ద కంపోనెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ద డేటాబేస్ మీన్స్ డేటా, దెన్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్, సాఫ్ట్వేర్, హార్డ్వేర్ అండ్ యూజర్స్ ఆల్సో. సో ద యూజర్స్ విల్ బి ఆఫ్ డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ సచ్ యాజ్ సిస్టమ్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్స్, the user groups of the databases are divided into different kinds. System administrator. Okay. System administrator. They will plan, design and check that the things are smoothly working and running. Okay.
So there is a database administrator, system administrators are there.
So if they have any problem in the system, in the physically, so that is having some problems in the hardware, so they will attend. So database administrators, the database administrators will plan and design to execute the things and assign the tasks to the application programmers. So the database designers, they are also known as application programmers. Application programmers, they will develop the assigned programs accordingly. Okay now. So system analyst,
then operators are the lowest level.
They will work with the systems which we develop. So operators means they will be given the manual instructions how to work with the system that you have developed, because they are not aware of any computer literacy or computer terminology. They are not the programmers. Even they don't know what is a variable. They don't know what is a variable, and they don't know what is basically a program is. So these are the things that will be developed in the database to maintain the database integrity, having the data access by using the different database languages. Okay now. So what are the functions of the database? So database supports database recovery and data integrity management, data accessing the language. Okay, security, high level security. Database can be used by multiple users across the systems. So the data is stored in a particular server, and in the server the database software is also there, but client will request the information and the server will process and respond to the databases. So that is the end of today's database advantages over file oriented system. Thank you very much.